It's juicy, it's tangy, it's saucy. It's the McRib, and it's back.
Lois! Lois, it's back! Kids! Kids, it's happening! Get your coats! This is what we practiced for!
Yeah!
To some, this sandwich is a boneless, mouth-watering masterpiece. To others, it's a horrifying symbol of what fast food has become.
But mostly I hate the way I don't hate you. Not even close. Not even a little bit. Not even at all.
No one can deny the McRib has a certain mystery. The McRib made its debut in the U.S. in 1982. It was developed by the same genius who invented the chicken McNuggets just a few years earlier. Unlike the McNuggets, though, the McRibs disappeared just 2 years later due to poor sales. But then in 1989, something incredible happened. George H.W. Bush was the president, Batman was the best-selling box office movie, and the McRib was back in action.
Grilled pork swimming in that sassy sauce.
Since then, the McRib has been playing a game of hide-and-seek with McDonald's menus. It shows up for a while, then vanishes for months, even years. Then, without warning, it comes back again. This back and forth has made the McRib a legend, with some fans so obsessed, they even track its sightings on a website. But if it's so popular, why does it keep disappearing? In this unit, we'll use quadratic models to explore the business of the McRib, how it's priced, how much profit it generates, and how its popularity varies over time. Then we'll answer the unit's key question, why is the McRib always back? Let's skew it.